Visit Kashmir, India's favorite colony. I mean, territory. The region that is famous for its beautiful mountainous landscape, delicious food, historical places, breathtaking scenery, but mostly for Kashmir. Fortunately, however, very few know about the real Kashmir, a territory of India since 1947, when we seized it from the Dogras, who in turn bought it from the British, which makes Kashmiris now Indian citizens. Wait, second-class citizens. In other words, Kashmir today is all about pellet guns, mass rapes, extrajudicial killings, missing persons, widows, half-widows. And to bring you to the ultimate colonial experience, we've made some cool laws over the years, like the Armed Forces Special Powers Act, which allows our soldiers to kill, torture and rape Kashmiris with impunity. That's right, hordes of tourists visit every year. But fortunately, few experience the real Kashmir, a region that we promise to give their right to self-determination.
Win people against their will with the help of armed force. And if the people want to part company with us, they may go their own way and we shall go ours. We want no forced marriages, no forced union.
Instead, now there are 500,000 Indian troops stationed in an area about the size of Switzerland. Today, each district offers a unique flavor of occupation, Kunan Poshpara, a place where women of the entire village were raped for hours with impunity. Badgam, a place where much recently an innocent man was tied to an army jeep as a human shield. Baramula, teenage school girls routinely protest here, demanding for the end of military occupation and harassment. And finally, Srinagar, where Bollywood and military occupation work together in perfect harmony by showing the world that everything is fine in Kashmir.
Kashmir, duniya ki jannat, Bharat ka dil.
Surely, there are UN resolutions on Kashmir and many people around the world are protesting the ongoing genocide, but zero given. Visit Kashmir, India's most favorite colony,